as we are cruising, celebrating towards the Pesach and cruising towards the conclusion of Pesach, Shvi Shel Pesach and Achim Shel Pesach, it's interesting to know that Shvi Shel Pesach, we commemorate the splitting of the sea. After we came out of Egypt, we were still in bondage. The Egyptians were still pursuing us. The final freedom happened when we crossed the Yam Suf, when we were the phenomenal miracle of the opening of the sea, and that's when we were completely freed from Egyptian pursuers. It said the Egyptians, they all drowned in the Yam Suf, and finally we recognized that the Yoisha Hashem, God has helped us, and that's when we sang the Shira. And in fact, this is what we read on Shvi'i Shel Pesach, as well as the Haftorah is David HaMelech's, King David's song and praise for him being saved of all his challenges. And the reason why David HaMelech is brought in, because the last 2 days of Pesach are very intrinsically connected to Mashiach. In particular, Achron Shel Pesach, the final day of Pesach, which in Israel they don't have. They only have Shvi'i Shel Pesach. They do not have the 8th day. We in exile merited to have this 8th day, which is a great day. The 8th day, the day of infinity. And it is the day when the Haftorah, which is read, is all dedicated about Mashiach, as it starts with the words, Oid Ayoim Benoiv Lamoid, where the prophet Isaiah speaks, standing in of the day will, the was still day, and the miracles which happens over there. And then it continues, it says, V'yotza choyter migeza Yishai, a shoot shall emerge from the stem of Yishai, talking about David ben Yishai, and goes on to describe what the time of Mashiach is going to look like. The girls gave him keves, that the wolf and the lamb will live together, and concluding with the words of the Haftorah, which is that the entire world will be filled with the knowledge of God, and Tzali v'roini yeshev es tzion, celebrate those who live in Zion, ki gadol bekir b'kidosh Yisrael, because the Holy One, who is great, is amongst you. Now, in other words, the final revelation of Mashiach. But at this moment, I don't want to focus on the Haftorah, I want to focus on important customs on the day of Achim Shel Pesach. As we said, Achim Shel Pesach is the day where the light of Mashiach, the energy of Mashiach, is actually revealed. And the Baal Shem Tov has instituted a custom that before sunset, towards the end of the day, we should celebrate what is called the Sudas Mashiach, Mashiach's feast, an actual feast, a seuda, a meal, a celebration. Now, it doesn't have to be an 18-course meal, but what is necessary is to have 4 cups of wine and some shmura matzah to be eaten during this meal. And thank God this custom has been accepted more and more throughout the entire world. And the idea is as follows. For us to recognize and appreciate that Mashiach is not just a thought. Even if we say every day, Ani Mamin Bemuna Shalema Bevias HaMashiach, I believe in the coming of Mashiach. But is it an intellectual concept? Is it an idea? Or is it something which is real? Something which is tangible? Something which is affecting us? Something which becomes part of our real life? Says the Baal Shem Tov, it is not enough just to think about it. It needs to be something concrete. Just like when he speaks in the Haftorah, the Gol Zevim Kev, it's going to affect the animal kingdom. It's going to affect every aspect of our lives. We too have to start experiencing it this way. By drinking physical wine, by eating a piece of matzah, we make it reality. We bring it down to our level. We bring it down to our experience. And then it's not just a concept, it's real. Share with you a little tiny anecdote of what means it's being real. The other day I overheard a little child, a 5-year-old child, asking his father, speaking Hebrew and English together, and says, Abba, yeah, my son, Mashiach magia, nachon? Mashiach is arriving. Absolutely. V'anachnu nelech im ananim. Are we going to fly with the clouds? Yes, it says. Either the clouds or the eagle's wings, we're going to be flying. And the little one looks at his father and says, Abba, what are we going to be on this cloud? Are we going to have to put on the seat belt? That's real. That's concrete. So my friends, if chas v'shalom, God forbid, this achron shel Pesach, we're still not yet with Moshiach in the Beis HaMikdash. Let's experience it. As I said, before sunset, either in shul or at home with your family, wash, eat a piece of shmurah matzah. If you don't have any, call any local chabadas and we will be happy to provide you. Local, I mean anywhere in the world. Piece of shmurah matzah, 4 cups of wine, and we'll experience the ultimate revelation of Mashiach.